Welcome back to our multi-part series on mental health awareness. I'm David Rodriguez, Public Information Officer for the City of Hialeah Fire Department. On this episode, we feature a rescue lieutenant. Lieutenant George Drada is a 17-year veteran and is currently working at Station 5 on C shift. It has been said that the rescue lieutenant is one of the most stressful positions in the fire service. Let's hear what he has to say.
What role, if any, does the mental health of first responders, and particularly firefighters, play in their everyday jobs?
Mental health is important. It plays a huge role in everything we do. How we interact with the public, how we interact with our fellow workers. It involves everything. How we come into work, the last call, the long call the day before, what happened at home, everything matters. Mental health is huge.
Have you ever been part of a traumatic call or scene, and how do you cope or deal with it?
Yeah, traumatic call, yes. 17 years almost, and seems like every day on the job is a traumatic call. If it's not one thing, it's the other. Even dealing with the simple calls can be considered a traumatic call. Why? Because we see things that other people don't see, how people live, how people survive. You know, the accidents are one thing, the deaths are another. You know, those things, they add up. You know, it's one thing after the other. And what do I do to cope? Initially, the main thing I always do is remember, this wasn't my fault. You know, I'm here to help. And the outcome, I'm not in charge. Man upstairs is in charge. You know, he's in charge of the outcome. I'm there to help. I do the best I can. We do the best we can. And that's how I deal with it.
As a lieutenant, what are some of the signs or symptoms that you may look for potential PTSD in your crew members or with your coworkers?
Signs and symptoms. This is where it gets tough, because for PTSD, there's so many things that you need to look for. Dealing with a fellow firefighter, somebody here at the station, and try to identify signs and symptoms of PTSD, it's really rough. All right, that person would have to exhibit complete withdrawal. They'd have to not eat. You'd have to physically see them, change their personality as a whole. And that can happen, in a matter of a month. It can happen in a matter of a year. And it could happen so slow that you didn't even realize it. We as firefighters, we try to, let things go. We try to ignore things. We try not to bring it up. Some people don't even say anything, so they never get diagnosed. They never go to the doctor and go through all those check marks and check boxes and say, oh, he was irritated. He didn't eat. He was withdrawn. He was angry. He started drinking. Those are things people do in private. They come here, they put a happy face, and unless you really know that person, it's very difficult to try to, look for those signs and symptoms. So, again, speak to the people you work with, get to know the people you work with, share. Yeah. That would be the best way to understand somebody and understand what they're going through.
What advice would you give a new recruit firefighter as a veteran of the fire service?
Advice I would give a new recruit firefighter definitely would be to build relationships as he moves up, as he continues in his career. It's very important. Those relationships, like I mentioned before, they last. You get to know somebody and you get to know them for the next 25, 30 years. That person becomes like your family. So the problems that you have that you can't take back home, you see it to your second family. They're the ones that are gonna help you through it. They're the ones that are gonna see you for who you are, how you are. Because we can't drag people into what we do, all right? That's where the problems come in. We gotta identify it, we gotta let it out, we gotta let the people around us know what's going on, and then seek out the help we need. And there's a lot of help. We can go through a number of different programs for people that need the help, that need to talk, that need to reach out. It's not just the people here among us. It's not just the people we work with. There are programs, and definitely build relationships. Don't take anything home. Talk about the problems. Make sure you identify what's bothering you. Don't let it drag on. Don't be afraid of talking to people. So you don't talk about it, you're afraid to say something, that problem is going to continue. And it could be something as simple as a call that you had that reminded you of a family member, maybe an issue they had, a problem you saw when you were old, young. It could come up automatically, and that's your PTSD right there. That resurgence of an issue that you may have had at one point in your life come back to, remind itself and say, hey, remember me? And then things build off of there. Definitely speak to somebody. Don't stay to yourself. Train. There's a lot of programs, videos out there for people to understand what PTSD is, because I think people don't really understand what it is. Best advice, open up. Share your career with everybody else, the people around you that know your career, not the people that are never gonna understand you.